morning, guys. So today is Saturday, February the 8th, and I'm just on the road today. Got a couple stuff to do today, and then I go in with my cousin them later. So that's that. So right now we're going and get some coffee, and it's like 62 degrees over here, but hey, you know, when you love your iced coffee and you gotta get it, it is what it is. So that's that. So we're gonna go ahead and go to Dunkin' Donuts.
Good morning. Let me get a, yes, let me get a small caramel frozen coffee.
Okay, small caramel frozen.
Okay, and let me get a plain bagel toasted with cream.
What kind of bagel?
A plain bagel toasted with cream cheese on the side.
Okay.
That's it.
See you at the window.
Thank you.
Let me tell y'all what happened at work today. Y'all know I work from home, but I do go in once a week to my actual job location. So I packed two sandwiches in here, some juice, my water, and some fruits, right? Normally when I go into work on Wednesdays, I always go out to eat Chick-fil-A, Chipotle, McDonald's, Wendy's, Wawa. I always get something to eat, Zaxby's, something like that. So I decided last night that I'm not gonna get something to eat because I want to be back on time from lunch, and I know that I had a busy day or whatever today. So I said, well, let me pack some stuff or whatever, and that should hold me off. I'm gonna be okay. Y'all, let me tell you, I went to lunch at 1 something p.m. and I did eat one of my sandwiches that I made, and then I ate some fruits, I drank some juice, right? Put it back. I put my lunchbox back inside of the refrigerator, and when I took a break around like 3:40 something or whatever, before I was scheduled to go to another meeting, this time a meeting with my manager, I went back and I said, well, let me go and check, you know, my sandwich. I'm hungry or whatever. Let me go eat my next sandwich. So I done and I open up my lunchbox. And look, somebody ate some of my sandwich. I'm talking like a bite and a half or two bites. I don't know, but they ate some of my sandwich. And I was like, it really had me second guessing, because I was like, wait. I know that I did not take a bite from my other sandwich because I done had one already earlier at 1 something in the afternoon. And I coming back to eat my sandwich and eat the rest of my fruits. That shit had me like so upset, because I had some fruits as well. You understand what I'm saying? Earlier. And I cut up these and I left these in here. I left the remaining fruits in here because I said, well, I'm gonna come back to eat these two along with my sandwich. But the thing is that because everything was done already, like open and being used, I don't even want to eat the rest of my fruits no more. I don't want to drink the rest of my juice. And I don't want to eat the rest of my sandwich because I don't know who been in my stuff and who touch it. I mean, my thing is number one, if you're gonna take a bite of somebody's sandwich, eat the whole sandwich and done with it. You check what I'm saying? Don't do that. Then point number two is like, what if me had no money to buy myself something to eat after I get off of work? Or what if this was like my only lunch that I have bring, like, and I ain't like have no time to eat nothing else or whatever the case may be? They went and done like savagely touch my stuff. Like, that's not even cool. I mean, you don't do that. I mean, could have left a note, something, you know, that's so like inappropriate, dog, like for real. So if y'all watching this video, you know, and something like this ever happened to Aya before, or y'all heard of this stuff, because I'm pretty sure y'all heard of it, but when it actually happened to you, it's like mind-boggling. So if this ever happened to y'all or somebody that y'all know, you know, leave that in the comments down below. You know, let's go ahead and let's talk about that. People stealing lunches or whatever. Let's talk about that down below. But yeah, so I will see you guys in the next clip, which is going to be on, I believe, like this Friday coming up. Valentine's Day, actually. I'm picking up my brother from the airport. Yay! He'll be included in some of the footage coming up. So yeah, I'll see you guys then. Morning, guys. So today is Saturday, February 15th. Happy Valentine's Day. I know Valentine's Day was yesterday. In case you guys are wondering, Chris, why are you in the bathroom? I just wake up, brush my teeth, wash my face. So yeah, about to go and make some breakfast now for me and my brother. And then we're going out to the store, and then we might go out later on tonight. Okay, so now that I have out the eggs that I'm gonna make to scramble, it's about 5 eggs. Am I the only one that like to pick out the white stuff or whatever off of this? Because I don't know what this is on the egg. If y'all know what it is, you know, leave it in the comments down below or something. But yeah, so I don't know what this is on the eggs, but I don't always take it off and then, you know, put my seasonings and stuff and then scramble it. So yeah. Flowers that I got from Keishla. There's some beautiful tulips. She gave all of us, you know, a bouquet yesterday for Valentine's Day. So that was so sweet. Keishla, if you're watching this video, thank you again. Appreciate it. And I put them in some water. They're so pretty. Okay, so down to the fun stuff for today. So I just came back from the store and I got a family size pack of Oreos because I'm gonna go ahead and put them here in this jar. Chloe K inspired. So yeah, y'all gonna get to see that. Stay tuned. Okay guys, so here is the completed look. I had to stop filming because I had to get the placements correct. So yeah, look at it. I'll try to give you guys a good 360 view. I think it is perfect. It's cute. Earlier today when we went grocery shopping, me and my brother, he picked this box out, you know. So of course, being the good sibling that I am, I decided to make it for him. So this is just the Baker's Corner. That's Aldi brand chocolate chip cookie brownie bar mix. So that's how it looks. I decided to make it like muffin style instead, or like cupcake or whatever. So yeah, I just have 12 here, and I have the brownie in the bottom, cookie dough on the top, and hopefully, you know, when it like rises, it looks very similar to that. Or let me show you guys the back, at least something like that instead. Yeah, so we'll see. I will show you guys them when they come out the oven. It took about 45 minutes to bake according to the box, and then I let it cool for like, I would say, almost an hour, And here's how they look. OMG, they look so good. As I was taking them out, like, you could feel the texture of it. And it looks a little like crispy around the edges. But when I was holding it to take it out, you could feel like it's nice and, you know, soft on the inside. So I can't wait to try these. They look amazing. Hey, no cursing on my vlog. So tell the viewers, what you have on that shirt? What is that? You're not my type.
Yep. Gotta let the ladies know.
So which one is your type?
You don't know.
Okay, we'll just disregard that.
Say what you still know about my eyebrow then. Yeah, he said, I just come from getting my brows waxed, by the way. But he said that it's a bigger noticeable difference now than before. So he was trying to say that I was looking busted before I do my brows. And now he said it makes a big difference and it looks way better. And then to justify his reasoning for what he said, he said, you guys, you're my sister, so I have to be honest and tell you the truth. Right?
Tonight, I decided to make some wings, white rice, and black beans. So I'll be showing you guys that. I'll come back to the chicken. So this is what the rice is looking like. I actually have to spin it. And then I just put on the beans. So waiting for those to bubble up. Yeah. So in here, I just make some honey and hickory smoked barbecue sauce. And I put, you know, a little extra touch of my own personal seasonings in here too. And I'm just mixing it together. And then I'm going to pour it over the wings. And then pop those back into the oven. Okay, so now that I have, you know, the sauce poured over how I want, I'm about to go and put the foil back on and pop these in the oven. Sick as I am, I still managed to do Taco Tuesday.
I feel a little bit better today. My nose still running a little bit, but I'm at the movies with Pooks.
I'm saving up all my pennies and my penny bank. So, it's there. Yeah.
We're supposed to be going to City Walk later on tonight. Yeah, so, I'm sorry. Yeah. Walk, come to show Raphael what it looks like. All the times that he's been to Orlando, I don't think that he's never been, and I haven't been here in like 2.5 years, so it'll be nice to see what new stuff they have and to show him around. You excited, Pooks?
We do.
Say something else. I still sound a little sick. My voice is still a little hoarse or whatnot. Sound a little man-ish, but it'll be okay. Thank you.
morning, guys. So today we are headed to Universal Studios. Choose to go to Universal Studios instead of Islands of Adventure because I wanted to go to the Diagon Alley for the Wizarding World of Harry Potter inside of there. So that's where we are headed today.
From Starbucks, I got the mango dragon fruit refresher, and my brother, he got a caramel. That's what we're drinking this morning. So last night, you guys didn't get to see the chocolate emporium because it was kind of dark, but this is what it looks like in the daytime, as well as the Hard Rock over there. And then this right here is the entrance to Islands of Adventure. But like I said, that's not where we're going. We're going to actually Universal Studios, which is somewhere over here. Yeah, I'm mad hype, like we're about to roll up on Diagon Alley right now. So I'm about to put on like my best London accent right about now. About to go to London. Y'all don't study with me, okay?
Oh.
So just got a butter beer. About to try it for the first time.
So far, the butter beer is actually pretty good. Rafael say it tastes literally like butter and sugar, but it kind of have like a caramelly kind of like taste to it too. It's actually pretty good. Rafael and I just got off the Gringotts ride, and let me tell y'all, it was freaking awesome. I mean, I know y'all can barely hear me because like my throat hurting me, but let me tell y'all, it was freaking awesome. Rafael, what you talk about the Gringotts ride?
It was visually cool. 3D was good.
And there you go, folks. He said it was really cool as well. The 3D was really good too. I must admit that. Right now we are at the Leaky Cauldron getting something to eat. Let me tell you, I live in my best life over here in this Harry Potter world, okay? Best life.
I got the specialty chicken with the wedges, and we got lemonade, and Rafael got, show me a plate, fish and chips.
Audience, are you guys ready? Then let's count down to chow down in 3, 2, 1, count! Slam it, girl, just slam it. You got it. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Oh, no! Dragon rides. Contestants, turn around. In 3, 2, 1, go! And away they go. Yes, using his brain advantage, right off the bat here. Smart strategy, gotta use it.
Oh my gosh.
They're both gonna have to contend with that watermelon little. Now Tampa with a second flag. Yes, it's short work out of that wall. He has his key to drop the roll. Let's go, Tampa! Pick it up! Alright, let's clear the wall. The angle of the car. Now that you've got your in the brake effect, you slide off the car. Take the camera, give me your cue. One there. Jeff, go! Yeah, on the hood.
One, no two. Way.
All relaxed. Now to the back seat. Boy, the rocket launcher taking you.
Inside of the Men in Black ride. Yes. I'm so excited. Chocolate Emporium, and I got the Chocolate X5, and Rafa got the Espresso Balls.
Right now it's like 7:30 p.m. I don't take off my contacts and switch back to my glasses because I am so tired. My toes hurt. Oh, let me tell you, it was worth every single penny, and I wouldn't trade it for nothing. And I want to go back again, this time to Islands of Adventure. We had a really good time. We had a blast, actually. Like, it was super cool, super fun, highly recommended. I just home now. I still sound a little congested, but I'm be okay. I hear boiling some lasagna noodles and just put some seasoning or whatever on my meats. I was letting that then marinate for like a little bit. Yeah, so I'm going to make lasagna. I know. Rafael asked for lasagna. I just have like these bumps like come out of nowhere. I don't understand what happened. Like, I get one here and I got another one here. Like, where the hell them two bumps come from? I was telling you, if it's not one thing, it's the next. We're going out of town tomorrow to go visit some relatives, and then my brother tell me he's taking me out to dinner buddy tomorrow night, because tomorrow night is his final day. So we're going, I want to go to the Cheesecake Factory because I haven't been there in a while. So yeah, I think that's where I gonna make him take me, to the Cheesecake Factory. Hey guys, so today is Friday the 21st and we are off. Sorry, still coughing. But we are off to Jacksonville to go and visit some relatives today. So Pooks is back there. Okay, where he at? Somewhere back there. Putting gas in the car. My bumps on my forehead have subsided a little bit, but they'll go away eventually. I curled my hair today, so I wanted a different look because I've been looking crazy. You know, my hair just been like in one for the past like week now. So yeah, Florida weather is so bipolar. This is why people are continuously get sick over here, because yesterday when we went to the theme park, it was like it was like low 80s, and today is like 52 degrees, which don't make like no sense whatsoever. Like, how the weather drop like that? Not good, especially for people like me that are trying to get over my cold. But anyways, I will, you know, vlog some more once we get to Jacksonville. Say hey, what's up?
Fright fest thing, boy. Richard Millie rose gold on my left wing, boy. Playing Jane ain't the free. You know the type of keys and queens my city make. And I probably
oh my God.
I just needed time to do what I had to do. Caught in the life, I can't let it go. Whether it's right, I feel like that. I could tell you crazy, but she kinda intrigued me.
Yeah.
I know I get on time because I like to move freely. But you can lock it down, I can tell by how you treat me.
Energy is electric, okay? My vibe is unforgettable. I leave impressions on people that last a lifetime, okay? Okay.
Some way, somehow, we're here looking for a remote for the PS, maybe PS4, for the PS4, and then and to get me a pair of shoes, because the shoes that I have currently right now, they are actually open-toed shoes. So I need to get me some closed-toe shoes. So I figure since we're here in Walmart, I'll just go ahead and get me one. I thought Larelli said that it was like $80 or something like that. Yeah, it's cold as hell over here. Over here is like 48 degrees. So yeah, so my brother on the phone now, my other sister, because they need to figure out what the hell they're going to get.
Light blue, white,
gold,
gold.
Personally, I would like get it in the camouflage, the camouflage.
You had that one already.
I like the camouflage.
Just get you the black one.
The camouflage one.
Can you see? Because in the glass, they get a camo blue one, and then they get a camo
the
green
camo,
one.
You get a camo, green one. Camo blue one. Camo
you get gold, white, black,
the camo green,
white, red, orange.
The camo light green look good. How much for every one?
47. It's been cold.
We headed to Cheesecake Factory.
Okay guys, so just got my food and I got the char-grilled New York steak, of course well done, with some green beans, even though I told him broccoli, but that's okay. And got some mashed potatoes, and here's my drink. So I got a guava daiquiri and raspberry lemonade.